of beauty. Today I have a beautiful, gorgeous model, which I'm going to do the smoky eyes. Welcome to our program.
Oh, thank you so much. It's an honor to be here.
Thank you, my love. Thank you. And you know that Armine done the hairstyle and the beautiful hair updo. And based on the updo, I'm going to do the matching makeup. You know that it's very, very important when we are doing the makeup, what type of product we are using it and how we are using it, okay? Now, these days in the market, there are so many great number one products which I'm going to use, such as Murphy, such as Huda Beauty, Estée Lauder, and Anastasia Beverly Hills, and MAC, and I'm using also Laura Mercier. I'm going to use the Tarte, and so many great. All of them are so good. Okay, but you have to be careful. Like when you're putting product together, you are not canceling colors to each other. For example, when you're doing the contour, when you're doing the highlights, you have to make sure that the colors that you're using, like dark and light, make sure how you are using that to show the glow of the face. It's very, very important. And today I'm doing the traditional makeup. You know that I'm doing like airbrush makeup, which in the future I'm going to show more airbrush makeups, okay? I already make my products ready and my model is ready. The face is already prepared, so it's very important to have a nice and silky and beautiful and clean skin, okay? More skin is beautiful and ready, so your makeup is gonna look very, very nice, okay? I'm going to start with makeup first, and when we finish the eye makeup, because it's a traditional makeup, so I can do later on, I'm gonna do the foundation and the contouring and lip, and we'll finish the makeup actually, okay? It's very important that I do have MAC, and I'm going to use the right brushes. I'm using MAC, the eyeshadow primer, which is very important. I'm putting the eyeshadow primer, and you know that eyeshadow primer, it's good that because it makes your eyeshadow exact the color that you're using, and also it long lasting, okay? So I'm going to use the small amount, and I'm going to do the, close your eyes. And you have to make sure that it's very important, the brushes that you're using for that. So it's gonna make your job much easier. You know, there is like different size of brushes that you have to make sure you're using the correct one. Because that using the right brush, it makes your makeup faster and much, much easier. Okay. I put this MAC. Like very soft and good, okay? And sometimes when I'm using the product, even the brands, the makeup that it's in the market right now, sometimes those makeup, it's not good for every single faces. It's gonna be different, so you have to have a different type for the different type of makeup. Okay, what I'm going to do, I'm gonna use the light color of makeup by Atelier. This is from Paris. I love it. And I'm going to use the light color first. It's like a little bit shimmery, and hopefully that you guys can see perfectly. And you know, it's important that when you're using the product for all over the eyelid, all I need is the corner, under the eyebrow, to the end. Because I'm going to use different colors, that's why I have to make sure that my colors is not canceled. other one. Okay, open your eyes. Look down, but don't close. I want to make sure that I'm blending really, really nice. Okay, and after that, I'm going to use the same palette. I'm going to use little more. Okay. I'm gonna use the corner and above the third line, which is the crease. Okay. You see how soft and nice and beautiful it is. I love the palette. This is perfect. And this palette comes like these sizes and all different colors, okay? The matching colors. Matching beautiful colors together in the same palette, so it's gonna make your job much easier because you know that you can use those colors. Okay, I'm blending towards the up, and let me see right here. It's good. I love it. And using the right brush. This is the brush that I'm using it. And more blending, okay? And you know that how important when you are doing blending is the key for each move. Okay. And definitely when I'm using it, I'm using the matching colors if I have to match 2-3 colors together. So I have to make sure that really, really match, okay? The light color again to blend my dark one because I don't want to leave any lines. I want to blend it really, really good. And if you see, I can match with the earrings and the dress. It's very important. Okay. Now the next palette, I'm going to use the Huda Beauty palette. I'm going to use the darker color, this one, because I want to do the beautiful smoky eyes. Okay, let's right. For the whole. Area because I already put the lighter colors above. Now I'm going to go for the whole deep area. When I put this one, I want to make sure that open your eyes. I don't want to put the colors more outside of the inner corner. So you have to make sure that putting exactly the color in the right place. So now I'm gonna use my blending brush, which I love it. Then I'm gonna start blending my color. This is great. And it's a very warm color, okay? In the past, I've done so many light makeups, like a red carpet, you know, like a bridal makeup and stuff like that. And today I decided to show you another type of makeup, smoky, which, you know, most of them, they love smoky eyes. But for me, I love smoky too. And it matches. Okay. Open your eyes. Look down with no clothes. I want to make sure that I blend it really, really good in the corner. This is a great combination. You don't have to definitely use the colors that they have in the dress, but today I decided to do that because it's going to look like very, very nice, but you always can use the magic. Okay.
So I'm gonna make sure that I put enough eyeshadow and it's blended perfectly.
You know, makeup also, it's very important that you know what you are doing, and you have to consider each different face, okay? To use the right one. I am blending really nice, towards out. And I don't want to go more than this, okay? This is the exact size that I have to do it, okay? Based on the eye shape. I don't have to go over than that, more than that. Now I'm gonna use my light one. And I'm gonna blend it again under the eye, the eyebrows. And it's a dark one, so it's gonna blend it really, really nice. See the way that you are doing it? It looks perfectly blend. And don't forget to watch Togetherness Media. Follow togethernessmedia.com, the program Secrets of Beauty. And their program is always good. They have 24/7 beautiful program for you. And download the free app. Tell your friends to follow Togetherness Media and watch their program. They have very, very educational, beautiful program. Bigger, so I'm gonna put the colors below the I'm gonna use the shadow. And also what I can do, I can use the primer to, again, to hold the colors look up. Sorry if it's inconvenient for you. And we're gonna show exact color, but if you don't have to, but this is another secret that you can do it, which I sometimes I use that. Okay, I'm going to use this color again first, because I can combine two colors, which is gonna look very, very nice. I'm gonna use again the dark colors. The dark color actually, right here. Because I wanna make it like really nice, sexy, smoky. Especially when you have, they have a big eyes, you know. Smoky, it makes more beautiful. But for the small eyes, still it's good, but I'd rather use the light color for small eyes to bring it out, but the dark colors is always good. Okay. So, let me see. Wow, this is nice. Okay, look up. I'm sorry, but I have to go all the way. And then I can take all the extra. That's not a problem. And don't make it like a line, you know, you have to blend it really nice. Sometimes uneven, but it's like, not uneven, even, but it's like more beautiful way that you're doing the blending. It's very, very important. That's the key in makeup. Okay, if I want to make this color darker, I can use black and make the purple or burgundy darker. Only in the corners, I'm gonna add a little bit dark. then we're gonna take all the extras out and everything, stuff like that. Okay, if I have the eyeshadow so far, good. The eyelashes, like fake eyelashes, and do the curl as long as you're not putting any mascara, okay? If there is no mascara, not a problem, but if you put the mascara, you don't use this one after, because it's gonna break your lashes and it's gonna be like stick together and it's not gonna look very, very nice. Okay, I already have here two lashes, 3D lashes. I'm gonna use which one. Match. Okay. Close. I love to try first to make sure it's matching with me. This is, I love this. So I'm gonna use this beautiful 3D lash. I love lashes. Do you like fake lashes?
Yeah.
Yeah.
They give another gloss.
Usually you do makeup a lot?
Yeah, I love makeup.
Yeah,
that's why I'm here.
Who doesn't? From 99, from 100 girls, I'm sure like 90 of them, they love makeup. Okay, I'm putting the fake eyelashes. Sorry. Because always start from the short to the long, and long is always. It's a very beautiful day, sunny, gorgeous, and the way that we are doing showing our hair and makeup part is like very nice. It's like we have a beautiful view and we enjoy that. So I'm gonna put this. Telling you because it's a little bit heavy, but meantime it's very comfortable, isn't it? You feel good. The eyeliner, I'm using NYX, and there is a Bobbi Brown. I love these two products. I'm using it, and it's great. So I don't have to put. I don't want to put deep like the eyeliner, since I already have a beauty smoky one. I'm just gonna cover it. Up there, and I'm gonna do the line like very just to cover and give beautiful shape. Okay. The MAC also has a very good gel eyeliner, okay, which I am using, but it's so smooth and nice. And you can use the right brushes. My brushes that I'm using, most of them 99, are Murphy brushes. I love the whole set. And I have tons of brushes I'm using. Tons of brushes, it means you have to have all the sizes. Let's see if you have, this is for the, if you can see it, it's like a very thin. This is great for if you want to have a thin eyeliner. But if you want to do a thick eyeliner, so you can use the thicker one. But the same for the same eyeliner. I mean the brush.
to your eyes.
Perfect. So what I'm gonna use? I'm gonna use the same gel eyeliner you can put inside of your eyes. Look down, but don't close my ear. I'm just gonna make sure I'm gonna put enough eyeliner here. I always recommend start with a thin line, and then you can make it thicker. But if you go thick, it's gonna be very hard to clean it. This is gonna be one of the secrets. You always go thin, you always go less, and then you can add more. But if you put more and too much, then it's gonna be very hard to clean. And then when you put the gel eyeliner, it's perfect, okay? And you can put inside and outside both. Can you see, my dear? Look up. And then I'm look down. What I'm going to do, I'm just going to put inside a little bit. Okay. Okay, I'm going to make sure that I'm going to do the even. Look up. I'm using the Huda Beauty, the face prime, the beauty blender, and also the face prime. It's exactly, it makes the foundation longer. Okay, I already mixed the color, the Estee Lauder, okay. And I'm gonna mix two colors matching with her skin tone. And before I do, also I can put the little bit like a shimmer so I can make the face like so. The best, I'm gonna use the beauty blender and start playing. and I use all these great shimmery colors. I use like most Huda Beauty product, and I love it. Hope you guys like today's program, today's makeup. This is one of them, which it matches very, very good with the dress. And you wanna see yourself? Thank you for watching our program, Secrets of Beauty, and hope you guys like today's program, and then keep watching Togetherness Media, and get the free app, and follow all their programs 24/7. Thank you guys, and see you next time.